My involvement with the network is helping me to get the broader picture, not only within my country context, but in a larger Asian African context. It is important because I don't think the struggles are country specific anymore. The struggles on forest tenure or legitimate forest products or pro-poor red strategies are now global concerns. And it is always good to know more about how different countries are coping with that. You find a lot of similarities. Sometimes what has worked in one country helps you to understand your country context better. Sometimes you also learn from the mistakes that the other countries are doing, and you don't want to repeat that in your country context. So any global learning of this nature with a global platform, which is a group of pretty serious guys out there, and I think that learning certainly helps you in your country context. And the fact that you are heading a group which is governance connected, as IID calls it, it helps you to influence at the right places. For example, we have the additional Director General of Forest as part of the network. We have the Joint Secretary, who is now the blue-eyed boy of the Minister of Environment and Forest, as part of our network. We have a pretty strong media connect, people who really write and who are listened, to those media houses. We have people from, for example, the father of joint forest management, a guy called Ajit Banerjee, he's part of the network. We have former foresters who are part of the network. We have very strong civil society representation. We have some small-time lawyers like me as well, who are part of the network. And so it's a pretty interesting mix of people who've been there in the business for some time, and people who are, I think, well respected in the sector. I would say in all the three teams that we are working, I think there is a sizable influence, I would say. For example, we just, two of us in fact, one in the government and one and myself, we actually wrote a letter that of course has the signature of the minister on NTFP, on non-timber forest products, of how bamboo should be used for tribal communities. And that letter is now the guiding note for using bamboo for tribal communities as a minor forest product, which was not considered earlier. So that's a huge influence which actually impacts millions of tribals in India for the livelihoods. So that's one very direct thing which I can immediately recall. Apart from that, some of our members are part of the red readiness work within India. So the red strategy that India has, or whatever position we have, is getting directly influenced by a member of our group.
I think it makes me a better advocate. Not many Supreme Court lawyers go to Malawi or see a Mozambique or see a Bali experience and then put that in their arguments when they're actually fighting a court case or when they're negotiating with the government. I see FGLG emerging as a good group, provided we leverage other networks or resources to continue this theme. Because the problem I see normally is a network like this gets supported by outside funding, in this case the EU funding. And when the funding dries up, the network stops. So I'm hoping that FGLG should continue, irrespective of EU funding or any other funding for that matter. Globally, and I think we need to, as a group, find resources and people to continue that thematic, focus that FGLG has. So that's at least the future I see for FGLG, because I think it has great value in terms of ideas, in terms of strategies, in terms of the experience itself of the group, which can help actually resolve issues on forest governance.